in that chapter, that is re-optics, beginning only I told the difference between geometrical optics and wave optics. So in this chapter, what we are going to learn? In this chapter, we are going to learn phenomena related with lights. Yes, interference, diffraction, like this. Okay. So in this, basically, the light is created as a wave. Yes. So first of all, let's see what is the physical optics. Yes. So shall I give one more time the difference between these two? Yes. So see here, what is the geometrical optics and what is the physical optics, so that you will understand. Okay, so this is some introduction, we can say. So see here, first one is geometrical optics. Geometrical optics and wave optics, or you can say it as a physical optics, okay? Or you can say it as a physical optics. And here another name is for this is what? Ray optics, okay? Clear? Now let's see few differences between these two, so that when we are going from basic, you will understand everything. In bracket, okay. So tell me, in geometrical optics, how light is traveling in the form of ray, hai na? Yes. So what I am writing, light is assumed to be traveling in a straight line. Yes, no? That's why we can use geometry, hai na? Sine theta, tan theta, all these things, because we have assumed in that light is traveling in the form of ray, that is in straight line. Okay. And this property is what? This property is what? Rectilinear propagation, hai na? What is this property? Rectilinear propagation. Rectilinear propagation of light means what? Light travels only in one direction. Rectilinear propagation, straight line path, we can say one line direction or one direction only. Next, in this wave optics, light is considered as a wave. Okay, light is considered as wave. Okay, understood. Right. Next one. So in this geometrical optics, what we done actually? Laws of reflection. Next, refraction. Refraction, comma, total internal reflection, total internal reflection, etc. are explained geometrically. Yes, no? We have proved this, right? Explained geometrically. Now, in this chapter, what we are going to do? In this wave optics, see here. Yes. Yes, Gayatri, diffraction and interference. Yes, yes, right. You wrote refraction, no? So I was checking, oh my God, I committed mistake or something like that. Okay, okay. Right. Yes. Okay, okay, right. Yes. That is what diffraction and interference. Very good. Now see here. For diffraction and interference, we are using Huygens wave principle, right? So diffraction and interference, we are using Huygens wave principle. Huygens wave principle and principle of superposition. This also I will tell you ahead. Okay. Principle of superposition means what? I think in wave also you have learned, na? In wave chapter you have learned principle of superposition. Yes, no? Yes, no? Yes, yes. Right. Good. So diffraction and interference, Huygens wave principle and principle of superposition is used. And if suppose you have to use or you have to explain polarization. For this polarization, we are going to use electromagnetic wave nature of light. Electromagnetic wave nature of light. Electromagnetic wave nature of light. Electromagnetic wave nature means what, Ray? Light consists of electric and magnetic field. Okay. What is electromagnetic wave nature? Light consists of electric and magnetic field. Means light is a combination of electric and magnetic field, we can say in general language. Understood? So by using that, we are going to explain this. Yes, explain this polarization. Understood clearly what is the difference between geometrical optics and wave optics? Yes. Any doubt? Okay, shall I go to the next page? Yes, Srishta, any doubt? Yes. Okay. Right. So noted, everyone. Let's go to the next page. And now see. Condition for applicability of geometrical optics and wave optics, we can say. Condition condition for applicability of geometrical optics and wave optics. Okay, what is that? Condition for applicability of geometrical optics and wave optics. What you understood from this? Can anyone tell me what you understood from this? We are going to learn one condition, yes, which will tell us when light will behave as a ray or when it will behave as a wave, we can say. Yes, no? Applicability. Geometrical optics, when it is applicable. Wave optics, when it is applicable. Yes, no? Right? So, see here. What I am writing? Listen carefully. So, see. So first of all, ray. So when light will behave as a ray, we can say. Or shall I write like this? Light propagates as a ray. Okay, I will write like this heading. Light propagates as a ray. Okay, when light will propagate as a ray? When the size of the object interacting with light is much larger than the wavelength of light. This you understood this point. Who will tell me what you understood? When the size of the object interacting with light is much larger than the wavelength of light. Who will tell me what you understood from this? Yes, what you understood from this? For example, let us suppose wavelength of light is something 5000 angstrom. Okay. Yes. Yes, size we can say. And suppose one particle is there. Let us suppose its size is X. Okay. And this is something, let us suppose 5 centimeter. Right. Now here you see this 5000 angstrom and this is 5 centimeter. If we will convert, this is 5000 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. Yes, no? Minus 10 meter means minus 8 centimeter only, no? Yes. And this one is 5 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, we can say. Or even if you want, you can write 5000 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Okay. So you see here minus 2 and this is minus 10. So if I will take this nearly, it is 5 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Yes, no? This is minus 7, this is minus 2. Which one is large? This one is large as compared with this. So here x is very, very greater than lambda. It means what? Size of the object is greater than lambda. Then light will behave as a ray. Sham, understood? Any other doubt, please ask. Yes. Any doubt, please ask. Yes. Okay. Okay, right. Okay, understood. Clear. Okay. Yes. 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 That we will see ahead. Yes, yes, Gayatri. Now see, next one, that is light propagates as a wave when it happens. See here. Or you can say light behaves as a wave. Light behaves as a wave. Okay. So when light will behave as a wave? Tell me. When? Just now only I told. Uska ulta hai na? When? When? The wavelength of light, when the wavelength of light is comparable or less than the size of the object, interacting with, when the wavelength of light is comparable or less than the size of object interacting with light, then we can say that the light behaves as a wave. For example, again, I am taking one particle. Let us suppose its size is, now I am taking, let us suppose how much, 1 angstrom I am taking. This is equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter, suppose. And this wavelength of light, suppose lambda, is something, let us suppose, how much? 5,000 angstrom I am taking. 5,000 angstrom. So now, which one is bigger ray here? See once, this is 5,000 angstrom. So this is how much ray? 5,000 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So this is nothing but 5 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Here it is minus 7, here it is minus 10. So now here lambda is comparable, or we can say little bit greater than this x. Yes, then the light will behave as a wave. Now I will tell you one experiment. You just do it and see what you have to do. See, but you have to take one precaution. Okay, you take two blades. I'm drawing one rough diagram. You can see here, take two blades like this. ब्लेड्स मालूम है ना आपको? यस दिस ब्लेड्स समथिंग लाइक दिस एंड नाउ वन मोर ब्लेड डाउन लाइक दिस something like this. I am unable to draw this internal design, so whatever it is, like this something. Now you take one laser beam, you take one laser laser light rehta hai na, you are playing with that, right? So this is a laser light and this is what the laser beam you are getting. It is monochromatic beam, hai na? Only one color laser is available in the market. You can take, I think so, 50 rupees you will get it, right? Yes, no? Yes. So after this, you do this blades you have to keep horizontal, means how vertical, right? Horizontal means just you have to assume that this is a palm of your hand and you are incidenting light from this side, right side. So these two fingers are there now, middle fingers, like that you are at that place. Assume that these two blades are there and in between of that small slit your beam should incident. And this side, you keep one white screen or wall, anything. Wall, or even whiteboard, whatever it is, wall. So what you are observing on this screen, what you are observing, you just tell me and you can make a video of this. Yes, can you? And one precaution you have to take. Don't see directly into the laser beam. Okay, what you can say, it should not incident on your eye. Always you look in the direction of that light only. Don't look opposite to the direction of light, understand? Don't look how that laser or where from that laser is coming. Means this is, suppose your eye should be here, Ray. Basically I am telling what, in the direction from here only you watch. Don't watch from here, okay? This is wrong. Don't watch from here, opposite side. If suppose this is a laser and this is what, suppose light is there, you don't watch from this side. Don't watch. Always watch from here only, okay? Understand, from here only, this side only you watch. Otherwise, it is not good for your eyes, okay? On that laser also, they have given instructions. So please watch from this side and just observe what you are getting on the screen. Understood? Clear? In this direction only. Okay. And see, then you will understand when it will behave as a ray and when it will behave as a light. Okay. Yes. Any other doubt, please ask. Yes. Any other doubt? Yes, yes. Okay. Should it pass through blades? Means by keeping two blades, you will get very narrow slit. For example, something like this. So you just incident on that slit. Rest of the things automatically will happen. Okay. This is a blade now. Okay. Something like this, okay? 3D figure it is, okay? Try to understand. And this is the laser light. So this beam will come here and it should incident on this sharp sheet, sharp slit. Okay, here. Okay? And here should be your wall. So what you are observing, you just see. Okay. Yes. Okay. Any other doubt? Right. Shall I go to the next page? Okay, so what should be that object? That also I will tell you in the next page or on the next page. First, shall I go to the next page? Yes, right. So see here. Now, number one point, that is the condition, first of all, wait. Because as I have explained now, same thing here. If B is the size of object, interacting with light, comma, L is the distance between the object, object and screen. This I will show with the diagram. 1 minute you wait. And lambda is the wavelength of light. Lambda is wavelength of light. Then number one or A, B square by L lambda is very, very greater than one, then this is what the condition for applicability. Of geometrical optics. Geometrical optics, or we can say ray optics. And if and B point if B square by L lambda is nearly equal to 1, or you can say B square by L lambda is less than 1, then what is that? Bolo, condition for applicability of wave optics. Yes, Isha. Now, sir, can you tell us with the use of diagram? Yes, see here. Now, L, B, and lambda. What is B ray here? Size of object. So, if suppose we have taken two blades, something like this. Something like this. And we have fixed it with the stand, we can say something like this. And now here, I am having a light source. Something like this, or laser beam or whatever it is, light source. And here, this is a screen. Okay, what is here? Screen. So whatever this size is there, this light is coming now. Okay, so this is light is having wavelength lambda. And the size of this particle is what? B, we can say. And the distance between this and this screen and this object, we can see. This is object, yes or not? Slit. So did you understand now how to check the condition? Yes. With diagram I showed you what is lambda, what is B, and what is L. Okay, understood? Sir, what we can create as an object? So note point here I'm giving. You see here what can be created as a object, we can say. Yes. Yes, what we can create as an object. So first one, a mirror, comma, a lens, a prism, an aperture, that is pinhole, okay? A slit, यहाँ पे slit है ना, a slit, next, a straight edge can be treated as a object. This may be like this, I will, these may be, or this may be object. Interacting with light. In this case, we are dealing with slit. Mirror, lens, prism, aperture, all these are the objects, but not here in this diagram. We have taken one slit. Hena? Slit means a small width. Hena? Small width. Separation, sharp, okay? So this can be treated as an object in this case. Understand? Any doubt? Clear? Okay, right. Okay. Clear? Okay. So read. Yes, 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 yes. So we'll start, we'll stop here only. Tomorrow we will continue. And in this chapter, I will solve problems there itself only. Mains and advanced model, okay, after each topic. Got it? So you don't worry. Right. Okay, bye. Enjoy the day.